Hi, my name is Kira Lynch.
Laura Beaver.
Renee Brooks.
My name is Diana Rollman.
Perry Heistad.
Hi, my name is Mark Johnson.
Yasmin Nkrumah Ellie.
Anna Harding.
Paul Meyer.
Hi, my name is Lane Tidwell.
My name is Molly Kyle, and I'm an environmental epidemiologist.
Isotope ecology, but I'm also a plant physiologist and an isotope hydrologist.
Professor of public health.
I'm a research ecologist.
Program coordinator for the Superfund research program, as well as the Environmental Health Sciences Center.
I'm a research soil scientist.
I study chemicals in our environment.
I am a toxicologist.
Oh, my day-to-day life is fun. Part of my job involves going to the field, which includes places like Bangladesh, to measure chemical exposures from drinking water out there. Part of my job is as a college instructor and a lecturer, so I teach students about environmental epidemiology. I get to work in the lab, and then I also do a lot of writing.
My job entails three main tasks. Going out into the environment and collecting samples, which is a lot of fun because I get to go to really neat places like the Gulf of Mexico or Ohio or Africa or Peru and bring back samples to the laboratory. The next portion of my job is taking those samples and analyzing them on really expensive, really complex instruments and doing some fun chemistry. And then after that, I get to sit down at my computer and take all the data that I get from the instrument and enter it into models that help us understand how these compounds move throughout the environment and how we interact with them as humans.
My day-to-day, every day is completely different. So yesterday I taught 93rd graders. 2 weeks ago I was in Ohio with a research team.
I supervise a group of 18 scientists, all of whom do research of various kinds, and I serve as their supervisor and mentor and help them plan their research.
What I really do is I work with data and I tell stories that I find within this information, pulling together things, trying to understand what the data is telling us.
I graduated from high school and was going to go to college. I had no idea what I wanted to do. I thought I'd follow my father's career path, which was an engineer. It was interesting, but I couldn't see making a career. Although I grew up in Southern California, my family were farmers in the Midwest, and so I was really interested in agriculture and started leaning myself or preparing myself for that kind of a career. So I studied soils, I studied chemistry, which I was very passionate about and really enjoyed. One thing led to another. I got a degree in agronomy, which is a study of crops and soils, and then I went on to get a master's degree in soil chemistry and plant nutrition, and then from there I went and got a PhD in soil chemistry.
I took a lot of science and math classes and enjoyed them a lot in high school, and then I went off to college and got a bachelor's in biology here at Oregon State University, and then a master's in environmental science, and then I took a little break and moved to Washington, D.C. and got my PhD in genetics. Along the way I did a lot of research in labs. I started washing dishes in a lab because I needed to pay for room and board, and then I discovered I loved doing science.
I became an environmental epidemiologist after first working as a marine scientist. I was very interested in learning about chemicals in our environment, and so I did that in the coastal zone and in the oceans for several years. And then what I realized was I was really interested in how those chemical exposures affected human health, and that's the basis of environmental epidemiology.
I went to graduate school for marine biology, actually, for several years at the College of Charleston. After I did that research, I lived in Costa Rica for a few months, working with sea turtles in Tortuguero, Costa Rica. And then after that, I started this PhD here at Oregon State in the toxicology department, looking at a different range of contamination, or a lot of different chemical classes. Basically, I started in biology, and now I'm doing a lot of chemistry, so I'm kind of a mixed bag. I know a little bit of everything, but an expert in nothing.
I have always known that I wanted to be a scientist ever since I was 5 years old, and I've always followed that route towards becoming a scientist, whatever that meant at the time. Started work as a postdoc with the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, and I've worked my way up through the agency and through the ranks.
I think my work makes a difference because environmental exposures are an important contributor to human health, but we need to have good, solid evidence before we can make good decisions about how we regulate those chemicals.
The Superfund program was specifically designed to deal with legacy waste sites. Many of the old chemical manufacturing and mining facilities from years ago, when we didn't realize that the waste handling procedures that we were using were really resulting in significant impacts, negative impacts to the environment.
I think it's really important to try and assess what the condition of the nation's waters are. We can't make water better until we know what the condition is. And this is a way on a national scale to try and figure out, is water quality getting better over time or worse over time, and what is it?
The research we did directly affected congressional legislation called the Amendments to the Clean Air Act that brought down sulfur emissions and has actually resulted in a lot of lakes and streams in the northeastern U.S. becoming cleaner and fish being able to live there again.
I've always really enjoyed biological sciences and the chemistry sciences.
I did a lot of theater. I did a lot of art. I also was interested in math.
My favorite class has definitely got to be AP Biology.
Probably my favorite class was literature, oddly enough.
I had a very lively, good chemistry teacher.
Biology, always biology.
Oh, my favorite class growing up, I had an awesome biology teacher.
You can just have so many great experiences in chemistry.
My favorite class in school, that's interesting, was actually geography.
I really believe that creativity is in art and in science is in the same part of your brain. So my favorite classes, I was a fine art major and a dual chemistry major at the same time.
My favorite class growing up was AP Biology.
My favorite part of my job is working with people. So I think sometimes people think scientists work in a lab and don't interact with other people, and that's just really not true. Environmental epidemiology is part of public health, and public health means people.
I think the favorite part of my job is when I get these results that I worked so hard to produce, and I have that moment, that aha moment, where I know if my hypothesis is correct or incorrect.
My favorite part of the job is interacting with other scientists from around the world.
My favorite part of my job is probably my field work, followed very closely by the work that I do at the bench in the laboratory.
My favorite part of my job is interacting with people, just getting to talk to people, hear what their concerns are, what they want to know.
My favorite part of my job is coming up with new questions. So I like to solve problems, and really that is the core of the research that I do.
My favorite part of my job is the impact that I know that I'm actually going to have.
Stay curious about the world and really ask a lot of questions about things going on around you. Be very persistent in trying to find answers to your questions.
Choose something that you're very passionate about. Choose an area of study that you just love. Be curious about the environment. Be curious about people. And be open to taking risks.
Get passionate about what you're doing, but be very good at what you do.
One of the most important things is getting experience and being able to really go in and be given a problem and be able to take that problem apart if it's really complex, to be able to break down pieces of it to come up with solutions.
Really find something that you're interested in. If you're not interested in what you're doing, you're not going to really want to go above and beyond sort of the minimum. And that's really what's needed in this field, is you have to be sort of passionate about the research questions and methods and approaches that you're using.
Just do it and pursue what you love. Continue to do it.
If you are a person who likes challenges and likes to learn things, don't be afraid to take on completely new things. Maybe if you've never done it before, it's okay. It's good to be able to learn new things at any point in your life.
Never stop looking for other opportunities, because you never really know everything that's out there. So don't be afraid to explore and maybe take a class or go to an event that might be somewhat outside of what you think you're interested in, just to sort of expand your knowledge.
Well, if you're young, I would say take as many science and math classes as you can. Learn something new every day and just get excited about it. And once you find your niche and you find what you're really interested in, go after it.
It's the thrill of discovery. I like finding out new things, I like discovering things, and I like telling other people about them.
I love thinking about how the environment impacts human health and how we in turn as people impact the environment and trying to make those the most harmonious relationships possible.
The best part about this job is that it changes all the time. So that's what I really like about it.
I like my job because it's different every day. And I feel like I'm on a sort of a voyage of discovery, kind of like Lewis and Clark. We have a mission and we're out there every day trying to discover new things, and it really is a discovery.
I love that the work that I do behind the scenes will impact thousands or millions or even billions of people. I think that science is absolutely amazing.